Hello, I'm Edu from Edu4Java, and this is the Android tutorial number 5. The title of this tutorial is Navigating with Intent. We are going to navigate from our form that we create in the last tutorial to another activity using an intent. The other activity we are going to call result. Okay. The first thing we are going to do is take this button, add, that say agregar here in Spanish, and we are going to fill the property onClick. The onClick property in a button say which method is going to catch the click. Okay, on add click is the name of the method that is going to catch the click. Okay, for cancelar, for the cancel button I'm going to put on cancel click method. Okay. These boxes, text boxes, if you remember, this was autocomplete text views. I need an identifier in order to get the content from the Java code. Then I'm going to put an identifier, book title for the title, book author for the author, and book ISBN for the last text box. In that way, I'm going to catch the content from the Java code. Now we are going to create the second activity, the activity that is going to receive the intent from our form activity. Okay. Here I'm going to add a result layout that I have already prepared, and I need two new strings constant. One result, that is resultado, result in Spanish, and result okay, that is inserción exitosa del libro, that say the insert of the book is okay. Okay, now let's check result XML. Result XML has here the string result as a name of the text view that we put as title. Okay, you can see in the layout. And I have another text view that use an identifier, because we are going to use this identifier from Java code to put the data that came from the other activity, that the data that we are going to send through the intent. If you remember, intent was like a message from one activity to other activity. Okay, we need to add the activity in the manifest. If you remember, the manifest was the principal file. Here I put activity, the name, that result. That means that we have to create a class result in the default package. And I put a label for this activity that is result, the string result, constant. Okay, here I bring the new result class that I have already prepared to. That is the one that we were talking about. It's going to use result XML. Is already added in the Android manifest XML. Okay, I think we have everything ready. Let's go to form and we are going to add the methods to handle the onClick events. If you remember, we create two methods here, onAddClick and onCancelClick. If you remember, the only thing you need is a method with the view, with a view as a parameter. Okay, let's see what we are going to do when somebody click on cancel. The first thing we are going to do is create a new intent. The intent, we are going to set the component with a new component that we create using a reference to this and result class, that is the class for the new activity. Then we are going to use putExtra to add data to the intent. In this case, we are going to add a string called cancel as a data with a label cancel. We can, and to end this, we are going to call start activity. And we are send an intent. Start activity. We are going to send an intent. The start activity is a method for that we get from the activity. The activity class. Okay. The result class is the one that is going to receive this intent. And in onCreate, as you can see, the typical call to the supper, the father, and set content view with the layout result XML that we already put is the same as any activity. And then we are going to get the text view component that we call result text in the ID. If you remember, we define in result XML here, we define a text view with an ID. With this find view by ID, we can get the component that we are going to use to show the result in the action activity. Okay, getIntent give me the intent that made the call. GetExtras give me the information in the intent. This information came in an object, in a bundle object. With the getString method, we ask to the bundle if it has a cancel data inside. If this is not equal null, that means that it has. Then the result text, we are going to set the text in the result text as operación cancelada. That means canceled operation. Okay, operation cancel. Result. No, it's not here. Let's go to form to see the onAddClick method. That is the method that we are going to get when somebody click on add button. Here we get a reference for the three components that where we are going to put the title, author, and ISBN in the form. Okay, we create a new intent. We set the class in the intent in reference to the result class. And this is another way to do the same that with set component. But I want to show you the two ways. Okay, then we put the data. We put the data in the intent with putExtra. Book title, we get the book title component, and we get the text and put this in the extra. We do the same with author and with ISBN. Then the intent have all the data. We call start activity and send the intent. Now I'm going to start the emulator Because if you remember, the first time take a little long, and while we wait for the emulator, we are going to see what happened with the result when the result activity receive the add click. Okay, the add click is not going to have the intent is not going to have in the bundle cancel. Then we are going to end up here. Here we get from the bundle the book title, the book author, and the book ISBN that we are going to use to fill the result text, as you can see here. Okay, we are going to use a string stored in the string XML, if you remember result, okay. And get string, this is the way we get a string resource from the Java code. We send as parameter the constant that identifies the string resource, and then you can see here we are going to get insertion exitosa del libro, and we are going to concatenate with the title of the book, the book title, the book author, and the book ISBN. Okay, let's test, run the application. We have to put a title here, any title, un título, an author, Juan, and an ISBN, like 222. Okay, 333444. There's agregar, that is add, and we get this in the other activity. Inserción exitosa de un libro, Juan. Okay, libro and un is have no space. We have the space here, but does not work. Okay, anyway, we can fix this in result. We can put just here a space, and this is all. Okay, yes. Okay, this operación cancelada is not okay here. You know, we have to put this in as a resource. Okay, the only thing we have to do is just get this string, change this string by a constant, and put this string in a string XML as a new entry. Okay, here we put this as cancel op, and we go here and just put get string. And the ID, that is r.string cancel op. Oh, I have to save it in order to get the compilation. String.cancelop. Okay, then back, press cancel, and we get resultado and operación cancelada. As you can see, here we get the on cancel click, we send cancel, in the result we get the get string cancel different than null, and then we get the cancel. Okay, that's all for this tutorial. See you in the next one.